وجمال الصوت وتزيينه وتغن فيه وتحسينه وسكون وقت تلاوته وتأن عند قراءته.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله الذي جعل القرآن شفاء للعباد من كل داء، وجعله خير منهاج للحياة وسراجا منيرا مضيئا للصالحين في طريق وزمان الظلمات. ثم الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الخلق سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وعنا معهم برحمته جل في علاه. أما بعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Last week, alhamdulillah, we were speaking about إدغام الأحرف, the topic of إدغام الأحرف, and we've mentioned it's quite a long topic. Last week we only done an introduction, if I'm not mistaken. نعم. So we said that letters in the Arabic language are sometimes merged together when they come in certain conditions for the ease of pronunciation. And Arabs, we said, spoke like this, yes? They sometimes merged letters together when speaking. And in the Quran, we must also merge certain letters together when they come in certain conditions. We said that letters meet in different ways, and I won't go over those topics actually, because we've mentioned them last week and it's all recorded بإذنالله تعالى. لكن it's shown here on the screen. Then we spoke about the four different relations of letters. And we, before actually speaking about that, we spoke about the two categories of merging of letters. And those are الصغير والكبير. We could call it, my dear brothers and sisters, الإدغام الصغير and الإدغام الكبير. Or we can just call it الصغير relation and كبير relation, which means the small relation when the first letter comes second, the second متحرك, or the كبير relation, and that is when the first and second letters are متحرك, are vowelled. And the reason why I said you could say idgham or not is because not in all cases, we do not always do what? Idgham. We do not always merge. Yes? Lakin, the general rule of saghir relation is merging. Jayid. Moving on to this, we spoke about al-mutamathilani wal-mutajanisani wal-mutaqaribani wal-mutaba'idan. We said there are four different relations of letters. Any two letters that meet, they will have to be one of those four relations there. Yes? Any word in the Quran that we look at, we need to decide of two letters that are meeting, yes? For example, when we're reciting Surah Al-Fatiha, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين. So now the ميم and the دال at the end, the first word, alhamdu. I chose those words randomly, yeah? Alhamdu. The meme sakina after it, dal mutaharrika. Is it a saghir or kabir relation? For the brothers and sisters that were with us last week, it's a saghir relation due to the first letter being sakin and the second mutaharrik. What do I now need to know? If it is mutamathilan, mutajanisan, mutaqariban, or mutaba'idan? You surely know it's not mutamathilan, because the mutamathilan letters are those letters that share the same articulation point and all the same sifat, which means it's the same identical letter. And that is like what? Ba, ba, and so on. So this is not the case. Al-mutajanisan are two letters that share the same makhraj but differ in sifat, whether it's one or more sifas, or sifat, yes? And this is not the case, because the meme and dal do not share the same makharij or makhraj. Then we got the mutaqariban. We said the mutaqariban will be close in sifat and in makharij, or close in makharij, but not sifat, and close in sifat, but not makharij. Now the dal and meme, are they close or far in makharij? Just thinking about it, yes, the tip of the tongue, the meme is just the lips, they're not far, they are close. Yes? جيد. And they have a number of صفات that are the same. So the ميم and دال now are what? متقاربان. So they are متقاربان صغير. Now there is one word missing which should be put before them. Whether it's إضغام or إظهار. Do I merge the ميم into the دال or do I show both letters? You show them. So it's إظهار متقاربان صغير. We're going to learn all of this. I'm just giving a quick like revision that will like just inshallah ta'ala remind you of what we were speaking about last week. Moving on from this, inshallah ta'ala, we're speaking about today's topic, and unfortunately we do not have much time, but we might have to stay a bit later today depending on the energy I have and the striving and inshallah effort that you guys put in, because we started quite late, and hopefully inshallah shouldn't happen again. Walakin, alhamdulillah, because this topic, after we finish it, all the other topics are shorter and quick and much easier. And I don't. This topic is very sensitive. If I start something, I have to finish it. So if I start one of the relations, my dear brothers and sisters, I will have to finish it. So I'm starting with Mutamathilan now. We will finish it, and hopefully we'll finish Mutanjanisan anyway. And we'll see what time it is by then, inshallah. Whether it's 12 or 1, I'm joking. Jayid, inshallah. So Al-Mutamathilan are the two identical letters. And again, just a reminder, they are the letters that, what? They share the same articulation point, the makhraj, and they share all the same sifat, which means there is nothing different between those letters and they are identical. Yes or no? Jayid. And in all of those four relations, my brothers and sisters, whether it's mutamathilan, mutajanisan, mutaqariban, or mutaba'idan, each one of those relations will have, in those letters that have that relation, there will always be either a kabir or saghir relation. Is that clear? Yes, there will always be a saghir or kabir relation. So we're going to start with as-saghir, which is generally what would we apply, my dear brothers and sisters? If there is a mutamathilan saghir, normally what would we do? Idhar or idgham? Idgham. We will normally do idgham. Saghir relation is naturally to apply what? Idgham. Jayid. However, there are exceptions to all these rules, my dear brothers and sisters. And that's what we need to be understanding, inshallah ta'ala. So, al-mutamathilani al-saghir, the two small relationship of two identical letters. If you want to translate it like this or otherwise, it's up to you, inshallah. So, the two letters that are identical, that meet each other with a small relation. That's the meaning of it. Usually, in any small relationship, we will apply what? Idgham. However, there are some exceptions to this rule. When two letters meet and have a mutamathilan relation, the ruling is to apply idgham in most cases, whether this is within one word or two separate, or between two separate words. Yes? Now, all the following examples that I'm going to give you, or I'll just make it short and easy for you, all the letters that are mutamathilan and have a saghir relationship, all the time we will do what? Idgham. Except for one or two exceptions that we will speak. Two exceptions. Yes? Two exceptions. So, let's look at these examples. We have starting from the first on the right. Unfortunately, the sisters do not have a presentation, projector. The sisters have the slides, inshallah? Yeah, Jayid. I didn't realize, subhanAllah. So forgive me for not asking. Jayid, inshallah. Let's look at the first example we have on the right. Awaw wa nasaru. Look at the way I've showed this emphasis on the second waw, this shadda. Awaw wa nasaru. This is how it should be recited. Not awaw. Awaw wa nasaru, the travel. And this is to show something that we spoke about. Now who's going to tell me? This emphasis I'm doing shows that this idgham is what? Who's going to be the one that is going to dig all these things that we spoke about in the brain, inshallah? Huh? Not in the books. Say it. Kamil, ahsant. Jazakallahu khaira. It is idgham kamil. It is complete merging, where the attribute and existence of the first letter fully disappear. Jayid? So that's why I say awaw nasaru. And always when there's a shadda, my brothers and sisters, just to make it easy for you, I'm going to give you this hint even though it's cheating. between menus cheating, because you guys are professionals, you don't need any hints. If there is a merging that's happening and the second letter has a shadda, it is always going to be kamil. If there is no shadda on the next letter, it is naqis. Yes? Jayid. I'm slacking now, I'm starting to weaken. Jayid. That's the first example. The first wa, my dear brothers and sisters, is sakin. Yes or no? Let's look at the first wa there. It's sakin or mutaharrik? Why is everyone silent? The first one is... How is the first one mutaharrik? No, no, I'm talking about the red waws, the highlighted waws. This is what we care about. So the first waw is sakin, the second one is what? Mutaharrik. Is it a saghir or kabir relation, my dear brothers and sisters? Saghir. Jayid. And is it, what relation is it? Mutamathilan, janisan, mutaqariban, or mutaba'idan? Mutamathilan. And will I apply idgham or idhar? Idgham. So this is called idgham. You could call it different things, my brothers and sisters. Some books say al-mutamathilan, some al-mutamathilain, some al-mithlain, and they're all correct, inshallah ta'ala. So say idgham al-mithlaini al-saghir, or idgham al-mutamathilaini al-saghir. Is that clear? Let's look at the next one. يَجْعَلْ لَكَ. Now you might be like, oh, this is المد sorry, this is اللام الساكنة rules and إدغام اللام الساكنة. That's an other than the form of تعريف. It's true. That's what we studied as. صح ولا لا? Isn't it? We studied the rules of لام الساكنة and we said this is إدغام اللام الساكنة. And the لام الساكنة here we're talking about is the one that's an other than the form of تعريف. However, when you're talking about the relationship of letters that meet, we could call this the heading of this topic instead of idgham al-ahruf, ikhwani wa akhawati, we could also call it iltiqa al-ahruf, the meeting of letters. Yes, how do letters meet and what do we do when letters or certain letters meet? Yes, jayid. But I said idgham al-ahruf, or I named idgham al-ahruf because that's what we are focusing on, which is when we merge it, because those are the exceptions in the Quran, or those are the less times they occur in the Quran. Jayid. So yaj'al laka. Two lambs that meet, the first is sakin, the second is mutaharrik, they share the same makharj and same sifat. Yes or no? Jayid. So what we do, what will we do? We will merge. Let's look at the first example. The first waw is in what? Is it in a condition of mad? Why? So it does not have a dhamma before it, so it's not from the jawf, it comes from ash-shafatan, the two lips. And the second waw comes from also where? Ash-shafa. الشفتان. So they share the same مخارج and same صفات. جيد. Let's look at the third example. يسرف في القتل. يسرف في القتل. I said like as if there is one fa. Yeah, but of course I'm showing it two, but we merged because of the shadda. Yes. فلا يسرف في القتل. يسرف في. There is a first fa which is second. The second is متحرك. And they have a صغير relation, they are متماثلان, and we are merging them, so this is إدغام المثلين الصغير or إدغام المتماثلين الصغير. Yes, and I've written for you here, it says we will call all the following examples إدغام المتماثلين الصغير, just for you to know what to call them, yes? The last example is an example actually of إدغام المتماثلين الصغير that occurs within one word. And there are two calves there, يدرككم. You do not say يدرككم, يدرككم, you don't do this, you do إدغام. You say يُدْرِكُمُ الْمَوْتِ, and this is in the all the قراءات. Yes, not only in حفص, or not in all the riwayat, not only in حفص. So you say يُدْرِكُمُ الْمَوْتِ. Yeah, يُدْرِكُم. The first calf is ساكنه, the second one is متحركة, and they share the same مخارج, same صفات. Therefore, they are إدغام, and we merge them, so they are إدغام المتماثلين الصغير. Is this clear or not, my brothers and sisters? جميل. Shall I move on? If I'm moving, I will prefer to move a bit faster. Is it okay with you or is this speed good? So, good or bad? It's okay, I don't mind staying this speed, but يعني obviously I want to try and finish as much as possible before Ramadan. So, shall I go a bit faster? Yes or no? Okay, somebody said no, so خلاص, we stay the same speed. جيد إن شاء الله تعالى. So, now we understand إدغام المتماثلين الصغير, brothers and sisters. And sometimes when I speak, I want response because I feel like people are sleeping, and then I feel like لا إله إلا الله. Looks like everything I said. But alhamdulillah, at least it's recorded. Maybe others, inshallah. So try and interact, inshallah. Try and be engaged. And if I'm too boring, just make dua, inshallah. جيد إن شاء الله جيد. So there are exceptions to this rule, my dear brothers and sisters. It says, however, there are only two exceptions to this rule where we will apply إظهار instead of what? إضغام. Yes? Yes, my brothers and sisters, we will apply إظهار, or there are two exceptions where we will apply إظهار instead of what? إضغام. The first, now there's a long paragraph written there, you can read it, but I'll explain it, inshallah. The first exception is when two letters that meet, or let's say, sorry, when the waw or ya meet with another waw or ya. However, the first waw or ya are in the condition of mad, and the second is in other than the condition of mad. So the first waw is sakin, and before it is a dhamma, and after it there is a waw that is voweled. And in the ya example, there is a ya sakina with a kasra before it, and after this ya there is another ya which is voweled, mutaharrik. So this will be, or you will understand it better when you look at these examples we have. Let's look at the example. Inna alladhina amanu wa amilu amanu wa. And a lot of, I'll come to this actually in a bit, inshallah. So let's look at these two red waws that I've highlighted on the screen. The first waw, and of course this hamzatul wasl that's in between the waws, it's silent. So imagine it does not exist. Yes, inshallah? Yes? Jayid. So, the first waw, my dear brothers and sisters, where does it come from? Al-jawf. Al-jawf. Yes, why? Because it's in the jawf condition where it is sakin before al-dhamma. In mad or jawf condition, so it comes from al-jawf. So the makhraj of that letter is where? Jawf. Are you with me, sisters? Jameel. The second waw, and please focus with me here, inshallah ta'ala, so that you understand everything. Because this is the way we are thinking of the rules here is going to be the same throughout this topic. The second waw has a vowel, which is a fatha. Now we don't care about this vowel, but it's voweled. Where does this waw come from? From the two lips, ash-shafatan. Try and use the Arabic terms as well, it will help you inshallah azza wa jal. Ash-shafatan or ash-shafatain. So do these two letters share the same makhraj, yes or no? No. So you cannot say, okay, if they do not share the same makhraj, then they might be mutajanisan, mutaqariban, or mutaba'idan. No. These two letters are identical letters, but they have something odd, which is that they, because you cannot say these two waws are not identical, these two waws are not the same letter. I mean, when you're looking at it, it's the same letter. Lakin, they differ in makharij. Therefore, they are not letters that we will merge. They are mutamathilan, or they are an exception of mutamathilan letters. Can I say they are mutaba'idan? Because if you say they are mutaba'idan, my dear brothers and sisters, you might think of it, and use your brain and say, okay, so waw comes from the jawf, the first one. The second one comes from the shafatan. They are mutaba'idan, they are far apart letters. But you don't stop here. You need to come to the sifat. And they're going to have the same sifat. The same exact sifat. Sahih wa la? Therefore, these letters are not letters of what? Mutaba'idan. Or mutajanisan or mutaqariban. They are letters that are mutamathilan. Lakin, they are an exception to the rule of idgham. Is this clear, my brothers and sisters? And a lot of these things you need to memorize because they're not repeated a lot in the Quran. Amanu, for example, this is repeated a number of times in the Quran, many times, yes? Lakin, it might be the same things. And there are other examples, of course, apart from these. Yeah? And what I want to mention here is that a lot of people and reciters I'm talking about here as well, subhanAllah, fall into the mistake of merging these letters. Or they do not show two waws purely. The first waw in mad and the second one. For example, they say, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. I merge the two waws. Instead of saying, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Now, of course, I'm exaggerating here. I did not fall in a mistake, but I'm making it very clear. Some qurra, they actually show this rule better than others. So, for example, like here, في يو آمنوا. Not آمنوا. For example, آوا. the example of idgham awwa nasaru. That's idgham. Lakin here you need to give the two haraka mad of the first waw and then show the next waw. Is it clear or not? So inna alladhina amanu wa inna alladhina amanu wa amilu. Yeah, the same thing here. Fi Yusuf, and do not cut it. Don't exaggerate. Some others will go to another extreme. Yeah, they will say, "Amanu wa amilu." Don't do this. Huh? Your voice or your sound, the sound of has to keep running. It continue to run. Inshallah. Is this clear? Yes or no, my brothers and sisters? Jay, very nice. If you understand this, Alhamdulillah, we are, inshallah, doing well. The second one or the second exception, where two identical letters meet with a saghir relation, but we do not apply idgham, is in the two ha's that meet in Surah Al-Haqqah, between verse 28 and 29, when we join the two verses. When you say, مَا أَغْنَى عَنِّي مَالِيَهْ هَلَكَ عَنِّي سُلْطَانِيَهْ. These two ha's. If I want to join these verses. So now if I'm stopping normally, yes, to stop between each verses, what do? I just stop, take a breath and continue. We do not care about the rule here. صح ولا لا? Yes, and if you have a Quran, of course, it will make it clearer. Otherwise, I've just written the two words I care about here. The first word is from verse 28, and it's the last word of verse 28. The second word is the first word of verse 29 of Surah Al-Haqqah. And, Jazakallah khair. In the Quran, it will have a scene. Now, I don't have the ability to put this little scene on top of the ha. May Allah increase us in knowledge. Which is one of the ways to, we'll talk about it now, inshallah. So, when the two hats appear together in Surah Al-Haqqah, if joining verse 28 and 29, yeah? So this is the second exception where we will not apply idgham. Yes? But rather we will apply what? Or instead we will apply idhar. Now, there are two ways actually of this. One of the ways is actually to apply idgham. Yes? One of the ways is to actually apply idgham. So instead of saying, if you're going to join the two ayahs, مَا أَغْنَى عَنِّي مَالِيَهْ هَلَكَ عَنِّي سُلْطَانِيَهْ. Yes? The second way, and now I did not write it here, but Allahu A'lam, as far as I remember, that I've read it or I've heard it from my teachers, that the second way is the preferred way, which is not to apply idgham, but idhar. Yes, to apply idhar instead of idgham, but to apply a ruling, the ruling of sect. Actually, I'll just give me a second and I'll... But inshallah, by next week, I'll even though if it's written here, sometimes you can't always go by the book. So I'll confirm this to you inshallah by next week. But if I remember correctly, inshallah, the second way, which is to apply sect, is better, or is the preferred way in the way of Shatibiyyah. Jayid, inshallah. And how do I apply this sect, my dear brothers and sisters? What's a sect? We haven't studied the ruling of sect yet, but we will learn it and we will study it in the future, inshallah ta'ala. Jayid. So, I'll show you the example of doing sect, if I was going to join both verses, and it needs to be you need to be careful. So, the pause will not be, so now if I was reading normally and stopped and took a breath, the gap is going to be bigger. مَا أَغْنَى عَنِّي مَالِيَهْ هَلَكَ عَنْ. I took a breath, yeah? Now, if I want to join both verses and apply the ruling of sect, then you say, مَا أَغْنَى عَنِّي مَالِيَهْ هَلَكَ عَنِّي سُلْطَانِيَهْ. Is that clear? Yes? So you just pause. So a sect, I've written it for you, is a pause without taking a breath. Now somebody might ask, how long is this pause? Very short. Yeah? As short as possible without takalluf, and not too long, of course, that it is, يعني, subhanAllah, yeah? Jayid. So I was speaking about the maliyah, yeah? Give me seconds, inshallah. Jayid. يجوز الإضغام والإظهار إذ كان أول المثلين هاء الوقف وذلك. جيد. In the book it says, this is the كتاب المنير في أحكام التجويد. It says that the second way is preferred, which is to do sakt. لكن I know that it's also possible, inshallah, to apply idgham, like we said, maliyahalaka. But this idgham, is it naqas or kamil? So I'll recite it. ما أغنى عني ماليه هلك عني. كامل أو ناقص؟ كامل. No, it should be كامل. Yeah, with the shadda. You see the emphasis, inshallah. جيد. Yes or no? Is it clear or not? نعم تفضل. So with a sect, when you repeat it, when you are reciting it and joining two verses with a sect, without taking a breath, understand? ما أغنى عني مالية هلك عني سلطانية. It's a light pause on the first ha. Yes? Light pause and you move on. Without taking a breath. Is that clear, my brothers and sisters? Shall I move on? Why is nobody speaking? And the sister side? Jameel. So, now we have finished with al-mutamathilan al-saghir. You know when there is a when there are two letters that are meeting and they have a saghir relation and they are mutamathilan, we will always apply idgham except if it's in two or if it meets the two exceptions. The first is if the first letter is in mad condition, which is it will only occur with waw and ya, by the way, where the first waw is in mad condition and the second is not, or if the first ya is in mad condition and the second is not. Then we will apply idhar. The second exception is only once in the Quran, which is in Surah Al-Haqqa, when joining verse 28 and 29 of Surah Al-Haqqa. We have two ways, to either merge or to do a sect, which is idhar of both has. When you do idhar of both has, or when you apply sect, you are doing idhar for both of the has. And that, Allahu A'lam, until now, inshallah, as far as I remember and as far as the book says, is that it is the preferred way to do sect. And I will confirm this to you by next week, إِذَا شَاءَ Allah. Is that clear? Now we're going to speak about al-mutamathilani al-kabir. Subhanallah. Al-mutamathilani al-kabir, the big relationship between two identical letters. Usually when two letters appear together and have a big relationship, we will apply what? Idhar. Whether the letters are within one word or between two separate words. But again, there are exceptions here for mutamathilan, my brothers and sisters. Yeah? Only for mutamathilan. And you're going to know this after when you study all of the four relations, you will become big clear. But my brothers and sisters, it's very important, and this is an amana that I am asking you to fulfill. From last week's lesson, today's lesson, and most probably we won't be able to finish all this topic. And I mean, like this whole topic, idgham al-ahraf, please, please, please revise every lesson until the next lesson starts. So I'm hoping that you've revised last lesson until everything's clear, and the last time you revised it was yesterday or this morning where it's fresh, so that you could be with me on the same page. And the same thing is for next week and until we finish this topic. Otherwise, you will feel lost and you'll be like 15, 20 minutes. Ah, no, now I remember. Okay? Jay, then it might be too late by then. So when there are two letters that are meeting, and they have a kabir relation, and those letters are mutamathilan, normally, or in most cases, or majority of the times, we will apply what? Idhar. But there are exceptions where two letters meet, and they are mutamathilan, and they have a kabir relation, where we will apply what? Idgham, instead of idhar. So that's what's next. But before next, let's look at the example, the first example, or the examples of إظهار المتماثلان الكبير. That's what we will call it. Or إظهار المثلين or إظهار المتماثلين وهكذا. So إظهار المتماثلين الكبير. Look at these two باس. بباء. We do not merge them. ببعض يدافع عن الذين آمنوا يدافع عن. Yeah, we showed two عينز. So this was إظهار. Two letters that met. They are identical. They share the same مخارج and or same مخرج and same صفات. And they have a kabir relation due to them both being vowed, we apply idhar. Now there are exceptions that we're going to speak about, which are, it says there are also a number of exceptions where we will where we will apply idgham instead of idhar as shown below. The first one is in Surah Yusuf, verse number 11, when the sons of, or the brothers of Yusuf alayhi salam, tell their father, وقالوا يا أبانا ما لك لا تأمنا. Now in the Quran, you may see, if you open the Quran, there is like a little, some people call it a diamond, yeah? Now, I don't know where they got that from, but anyway, you could call it a diamond if you want. Yeah, now, in the Quran, on the example I've written for you, in the Quran, it's not written like this. It's written with one noon, and that noon has this alama, this sign. Yes? Diamond, if you want to call it. Yeah? Now, what this diamond means, or what this alama means, I don't want to call it diamond, يعني, inshallah, بس, على كلن, you could call it diamond if you like. This sign in the Quran, what does it mean? The rule here, or the word originally, my dear brothers and sisters, is like I've written in the presentation, with two noons. تَأْمَنُنَا مَا لَكَ لَا تَأْمَنُنَا تَأْمَنُنَا. That's the origin of the word. Now the Arab, of course, for the ease of the recitation, now, this is of course in the way of Hafs min al-Tariq al-Shatriya, this is the way we recite it. You have two ways to do it. You will either merge the two letters. And if merging the two letters, this is in this specific word, and there is only this rule that I'm going to speak about now, my dear brothers and sisters, is only repeated once in the Quran. It only occurs once in the Quran, which is in Surah Yusuf, verse number 11. So, here we have two options. The first is to apply idgham, and that's the exception we're talking about, yeah? The exception to the mutamathilan kabir, where we do not apply idhar, instead we will be applying idgham, is this one, A. Which is to apply idgham, and this will fall under the rule of al-ishmam. Al-ishmam, or if we go back to the word shem, shem is the smell, or to smell something. Anta shum al-shay, to smell something. In the Arabic language I'm talking about. Now here, coming to the ruling or the tajweed, science of Quran and tajweed, al-ishmam here is to bring a smell of something, if you want to think of it in this meaning, yeah? Now I've put in between brackets the definition of al-ishmam, very short and summarized. It is to merge the two noons, to merge what here? To merge the two noons with dhamm of the two lips. So you will merge the two noons, and this is one of the rules that you will only have to listen to the teacher. You listen to the sheikh. Some rules in the Quran, my brothers and sisters, like Tasheerul Hamza, A'jami, you cannot correct it until you recite it to your sheikh or hear your sheikh recite it. Yes? Now, some books of Tajweed, I will come to this actually, but before that, the word originally is ta'manuna. There are two ways in Hafs. The first is to do ishmam, which is the merging. You will just pronounce one noon, but you will do dhamm with your lips. You'll merge the first noon into the second. So you're going to pronounce the second noon purely. How do I do this? You need to look, inshallah, and you say, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم قالوا يا أبانا ما لك لا تأمنا على يوسف ما لك لا تأمنا تأمنا. Now it is very, very like delicate. You need to, of course, the professionals, they will hear it. Not only they need to see it. Now maybe you guys will have to look in order to know, have I done it or not? But if you close your eyes and pay attention to the difference, you will tell. I tried it with my students. We don't have enough time to do it here. But I tried it with my students. I've told them, close your eyes. And I will say the correct one with bum, and the incorrect one without bum, saying ta'manna. A lot of people might go past and say, ma laka la ta'manna, and that's wrong. It should be, ma laka la ta'manna, ta'manna. And the better the reciter would be, the clearer it would be without looking. Because some tajweed books, I've read it in one tajweed book actually, said in English, I think, it said, the hearer, what did it say? The person that sees can see it, but they said the seer can see it, and the hearer cannot hear it. So if you are listening, you will not hear it. If you're looking, you'll hear it. And this is wrong. Wrong in many ways. Why? Some of the strongest shuyukh in the world and teachers and muqri'een are blind. How are they going to know if the student is doing it right or wrong? That itself tells the book that you are wrong. And you will hear these shuyukh stop you just like this if you are reading to them. And you'll be like, subhanAllah, he can't even see my lips. But this is where the profession comes in. And all of you now, if I was to try it, inshallah, you would be able to tell the difference. So I will say the wrong one. Ta'manna, ta'manna. You will feel a bit of pressure on my lips without even looking. If you just imagine the lips and listen without looking, you will notice this, inshallah ta'ala. Jayid? So this is the first way, which is to do al-ishmam. The second way that you are able to do is idhar. Now, if you're applying idhar, then it's not going to be what? An exception, is it? Because you're doing idhar. However, you will do idhar of both noons, even though there's only one written, but you will do something which is called ikhtilas, which is the stealing of the ikhtilas is pronouncing both noons clearly, but stealing part of the dhamma of the first noon. So instead of giving the full dhamma, some books say two-thirds or one-third, you pronounce one-third or two-thirds of the dhamma, lakin it's just to say the dhamma of the first noon quick and steal it and run away. For example, you say, قَالُوا يَا أَبَانَا مَا لَكَ لَا تَأْمَنُنَا عَلَى يُوسُفِ. You see how I rushed on the first noon, or on the dhamma. And that's what's ikhtilas. So you stole part of the first letter's vowel. And that's ikhtilas. And a lot of the times when you're reciting Quran to a sheikh, they might tell you, do not do ikhtilas, do not do ikhtilas, because you will steal. A lot of people steal vowels throughout the recitation. Yes? Or even letters. You should not do ikhtilas. Except if there is a ruling of ikhtilas like this, which is the only one. In the qira'ah of Hafs, this is the only ikhtilas that we will be doing. Okay? Are two ways possible, or two ways clear. When I'm doing idgham, which is the exception, and which falls under the ruling of al-ishmam, or whether I'm doing idhar, and I'll be applying ikhtilas. Is this clear, my dear brothers and sisters? Yes or no? Yes? Sisters? Jameel, let me move on. There are six exceptions, yeah? So the first one was in Surah Yusuf. There are five other ones. The first one is in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 271. فَنِعِمَّاهِ. This word فَنِعِمَّا. Originally this word, my dear brothers and sisters, is in it's two words anyway. فَنِعِمَّا. 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 Or فَنَعِمَّا. فَنَعِمَّا. The first meme, متحرك. The second one, also متحرك. This word, فَنِعِمَّا, is originally فَنَعِمَّا. Yes? Shall I write on the board? Jayid. So, فَنَعِيمَ مَاهِ. So these are merged together. So we say, instead of فَنَعِيمَ مَاهِ, فَنِعِمَّاهِ. And there are, of course, differences in the qira'at. In the 10 or 20 riwayas, there are differences. Lakin in the qira'ah or the riwayah of Hafs, we will be merging the two letters. So this is an exception to the ruling of idhar, isn't it, my dear brothers and sisters? Normally in kabir, or it's an exception to the ruling of al-mutamathilaini al-kabir. Because normally in al-mutamathilaini al-kabir, we will apply what? Idhar. Lakin here, we will be applying idgham instead. Yeah? So we will say فَنِعِمَّاهِ, and that's where the ghunna is coming from. Yeah? Same thing in the next word, which is originally like this. نَعِمَمَا. Yeah? Which is in Surah An-Nisa, verse 58. نِعِمَّا. نِعِمَّا. You see this meme with a shadda? It's originally two memes. Got it? So this here is basically turned into فَنِعِمَّا. So these two memes are merged like this. Yeah, for the ease of recitation. This is how the Arabs recited it, or some of them. Or this is one of the riwayat of the Quran, yeah? Going to the third example, my dear brothers and sisters. In Surah Al-An'am, verse 80, وَحَاجَهُ قَوْمُهُ قُلْ أَتُحَاجُّونِ. So now this مَدْ لَازِمْ كَلِمِ مُثَقَّلْ. And there are two of them in this in the example here. Actually, there's a mistake here. There should be a shadda there. أتحاجون. Yeah, أتحاج. That's how it should be. جيد. I will resend it to you, inshallah. So أتحاج. So this has made it مد اللازم الكلمي المثقل. And جون also مد اللازم الكلمي المثقل. Now it's originally أتحاجونني. It's originally. Oh, if I stand up, it's gonna. So it's originally. أتحاجونني. Yeah, and these two noons are merged and they become أتحاجوني. Is that clear? Yes, brothers and sisters. جميل. So same thing. أتحاجوني. This is an exception to the ruling of المتماثلان الكبير, where we will normally do إظهار. We are doing instead here إدغام. The next one in Surah Al-Kahf, verse 95. ما مكنني فيه. Yeah, ما مكنني. Originally ما مكنني. Originally it is مكنني. It became these two noons into one, saying مكنني. Yes. Yeah. ما مكنني. So you are merging the two noons together. And it's an exception to the ruling because there are two letters that are identical. They share the same makhraj, same sifat. And they have a kabir relation. They are both vowelled. However, we are applying, instead of idhar, an odd or an exception to that, which is idgham. The last one. تأمروني. Again, madlazim. And originally it's تأمرونني. تأمرونني. Two noons again, which are merged together. And that's in Surah Al-Zumar. In verse 64. Is this clear, my dear brothers and sisters? Yes or no? Huh? Jameel. Any questions? Is it all clear, sisters? Sisters, brothers, clear? Yes? Sister side? Jameel. Any questions? Because now what's next is Al-Mutajanisan, but I am not going to start on that. As much as I would love to, but if I do, then it's a big problem. Even though I really wanted to finish it. Next week, بإذن الله عز وجل, hopefully we'll be starting on time. Inshallah. Even though I'm here usually on time, ولكن خير inshallah. So what we will be doing is speaking about متجانسان next week, inshallah ta'ala. And then المتقاربان, mashallah. And then المتباعدان. متباعدان obviously is very easy. So we will see if we could do that, inshallah. Yes? Sorry, brother. Here you go. Any questions, my brothers and sisters? Or do you want me to continue? Start? Inshallah. That was. I was thinking, mashallah, yani. Allahumma barik. Jayd, inshallah ta'ala, I don't think there are any questions. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you all. Jazakum Allahu khayra wa barakallahu feekum. Forgive me, my brothers and sisters, for always delaying you. Lakin inshallah, it's all with reward, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our steps coming here and make them a intercedia for us on the day of judgment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wipe our sins with the time that we spend here. جزاكم الله خيرا وبارك الله فيكم. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, نستغفرك ونتوب إليك.
وجمال الصوت وتزيينه وتغن فيه وتحسينه وسكون وقت تلاوته وتأن عند قراءته.